God must have made you on the eighth day. Your proof that he rested on the seventh to make something so precious he had the first.
Hey! I can bless you, I bless you. Anyway, from wherever you're catching us from, I want to say thank you very much for watching. And of course, Ruyonga.
Yep, you know what it is.
You remember that song there, huh? So got to remark a bit at Tutuse.
I stepped up the plane like, Tutuse. Ask them about me. Babuze, I'm here chilling with Anderson Luze, that guy came from that name, Bamitani, Ryonga. Need to be killed, tell what in song of flows, we keep chill, no need of a refill, do whatever we feel, I'll do more later, but yeah.
Yes, it is Ryonga Hemtown, of course, during the lockdown, I saw your online concert. I want us to start from there.
Yeah. Basically, man, I felt like we needed to do something like that. The industry, like, I feel like I did that for many reasons and also on behalf of the culture to show them that, you know, even when everything seems set up against us, you can still find a way to do this music for the people, you know. Like I felt like it had to happen. So so now, they had said no more shows.
Yeah.
So I was like, but did they really say you can't do anything?
Yeah.
They said you can't perform in bars, so I found a way to go online
I like the people who are playing the instruments. But anyway, what was
It was actually Lamar, Sam, and DJ Steph.
Yeah.
He DJed, you know, hip-hop, one DJ, two turntables. So yeah, so that one, we wanted to do it with a more semi-live feel. So it was just the DJ, me, and the people who sang in the back. Shout out to Star. And Felicity,
because
they're on the label.
I watched the concert. I felt like no, but we had to play it here, and I was like, even without your knowledge, and
man, I appreciate that.
It was very beautiful. Cut away from that, everyone is into black market. You know, every good artist that we are having in the country, from the likes of Angela Katatumba, you know, to the Daddy Andres, to the Nina Rose, everyone is in black market.
Yep.
So how are you? What's your partnership with Black Market?
360 Black Market. I feel like it's a privilege right now to work with a label that really seems to know what they're doing.
Yeah.
Because there are many labels that come up, and you know, there are some labels that have solidified themselves as a bit of a monopoly.
Yeah.
You know, and you can't all be on one label sometimes. So it's nice to have an alternative label that is still open to having new and fresh talent.
So what is it
on
that
there?
Black Market is doing for you?
Black Market, we're doing, you know, it's just the label, marketing, distribution, making sure we are heard by as many people as possible all over the world. So it's a global distribution
deal.
So
that means they pay for the audios and then the videos, the entire production, they do the finance.
I mean, everyone has their different deals, but like they work with you. Like
because
those
I
things are.
Now you're so many. So if you're very many, I'm wondering how they can, you know, do you get enough time with them over? Because, man, you're too many, and they're having other people in different countries also.
Yeah, the way I see it is it's an opportunity, but you don't just take it like, oh, they're going to do all the work for you.
Yeah.
Because obviously they are very many, you know, like especially with labor situations like that, you make sure you put in the work and you do what you're supposed to do.
Yeah.
And then they work with that. So they are very good with working with what you have.
Yeah. So let's talk about this main song, you partnering up with Ykee, Benda.
Man.
I want to know, who brought the suggestion, you know, of you partnering up?
No, I mean, I met him around the time of his concert. Last year or the year before? Yeah. Yeah, but when I told him I always wanted to do a song with him. Mm-hmm. And then we just talked and then we left it there. But man, I was like, I didn't want to just say that. Because I think that Ykee is a very talented guy. He's a talented musician, talented businessman. So I reached out to him and I was like, yo, I want to do this song. He was like, man, if you have something that works, then maybe we can do something. So I reached out to Josh SB 360. He does a lot of our content. And he had a beat that just, Ykee was like, let's go.
I'm imagining all the artists that we are having in the country, why Ykee Benda? Why his touch? Why is it that he worked for you?
Ykee represents for the people, like locally, while still having an international mentality.
Yes.
So like Ykee's song, it's not surprising to me that Ykee did a song with Jason Derulo, or Ykee was part of that situation, because his whole vibe is he works with what is there.
You've been there, and also you've done it all. Janelle Zamba is also in the country.
Yeah.
Wagwan, when it comes to, you know, rappers who do English, does it have really that market? Because I remember the last time we had a chat, I don't know how many years ago, then
yeah.
it was like, does really English sell more so when you're a rapper? Because we look at the people like Anga Juliana Kanyomozi, Nga Ria Tandikao, you know, that music, which was so beautiful in English.
Yeah.
And, you know, the publicity wasn't there, not until we again that local. So does it work for you as rappers?
I think it can, but I think it doesn't have to mix in, you know, some of your stuff. Like for me, I've always had the opportunity to represent, like I'll throw in something from, I'm a Munyoro, I'm part from Ankole, you know, I mean, I live in Central, which is Uganda. So like,
we mix, yeah. So I can talk about Runyoronga or mixing, I'm going to tell them about
it. Ta!
Why?
Because I understand it more than I speak it.
When people are proud of where they come from.
No, I'm very proud of where I come from. It's just, I'm proud enough to know that I don't speak it that well. So until I do, then we're just going to keep it here. But these days, I'll come and shock you.
So this is the brand new song.
Yeah.
Who published, is it The Black Market? Or it was you? You know, when it comes to social media.
The social media, like, I mean, it's my social media handles, but they have a whole team. So everything I do, they double up. So it's nice working with a team, like a team that knows what they're doing and they're dedicated to you and they're dedicated to making sure that everything goes well, you know, my way here. Why not? Long story, but you couldn't. Because, yeah, so they made sure that I got here. Otherwise, yeah, I mean, like, those
that
little things awesome, help. Yeah.
Because
again,
you
yeah.
get so busy. I'd rather work with the management.
No, yeah, it's good to have management.
Why don't you come up with something?
No, I'd love to. Just, I'm going to reach out to him. GNL is my type. That's and I have mad respect for GNL. Like, it's nothing to get in the studio with GNL. Yeah, just depends on what his schedule is like.
So let's put these people together. If you can look at Navio and then, let me say, Gravito Mutuju, who would you listen to?
Who would I listen to? I listen to Navio.
Why?
I listen to Navio because of a few things. One, Navio, I mean, it's the stuff that it sounds more like the stuff that I know.
Yeah.
Two, I mean, the antagonism is not as much. I like Gravity. I listen to it, but sometimes I feel like every time I'm listening to Gravity, like he's poking holes at someone.
Yeah.
So sometimes, like, that's not my vibe.
This is how put it.
No, but I mean, I'm for one amundeke. But I respect the man's business acumen. Like, he's done a lot of things in this industry for hip hop. You know, I can respect that.
Yeah, but English raps do pay, right?
I mean, they do, but okay, now,
like
as I was about to say, now, Fefe, Fik.
And Uganda, but I'm Uganda, then I'm going to take it. And when it comes to people who speak English, I'm going to have campus girls. Those campus girls are broke.
No, I think
and
you can. No, by the way, because there are also a bunch of Luga floor rappers who are broke. So it's not that simple. And there are some guys who now, I mean, as in Navio has had quite a successful career. Like,
Navio, Ryonge, wamwe muri bagaga bakora.
But the business, how you handle business, like how you handle your business. Because I'll say on the same thing, the guys are talking about how, hey, you know, calligraph. We pull up videos of the guys who are here and the type of stuff they've been doing. Eh? Guys are burying cars in the ground. Yeah, guy put a car on fire, then he went to the beach and he sat on it. What, like, cousin? Guy,
when it comes to you.
Ah, man, me, I'm born again.
Yeah,
I'm a born again Christian. I've always been. I feel like we have this conversation every time that I come here because,
I'm imagining on Sajo Mrokole or Limo video no kwata kuba baby. Does it really antagonize concourse here with God?
My career is my career. Like, I keep it respectful, one, but two, I've been given the opportunity to do music. God gave me that opportunity.
Yeah.
So, I mean, he wouldn't have given it to me if, you know, certain things were not. I mean, I keep it respectful.
Let me imagine, because people like you, Mbando, that challenges you meet when it comes, you know, to your music and your career. Do you
Mama. If you love music, you have to face challenges. And you have to face challenges to continue doing it.
A person like you, I'm being specific, like you, what
like
challenges
me?
Do you face? And you're like, man, when you know, it's hard.
No, I mean, for me, because I've been in the game for so long, I have to continue to be relevant while still staying true to myself. I become irrelevant, and that is, that. As in that, then the music, that's the move.
Yeah.
You get it? Eh? I mean, I'll just give the example of, we had all these plans to do this music this year, because we'd kind of been on break, and then COVID happened. And man, I wasn't moving around in a sticker, like a car with a sticker, none of that stuff. Mm-hmm. Like, we walked. I don't want to get into specifics, eh? But we walked, like, to do that show, it was a sacrifice, but it was a passion, and it was something I'll do again and again and again,
and
because...
I love your red cap, you know. Cape ya red day,
Black market. Hey! To gain the movie yellow and red.
As you're winding up, what is it that you love to tell Ugandans?
We need unity.
Yeah.
We need to keep the peace. And we need to understand each other, you know? Yeah. Like, some people feel like this is the way to go in terms of color. This is Black Market Records, by the way. And other people feel like the other color is the way to go. And you have to respect each other in that regard. Whoever does the best wins. Is it? Saala video has just dropped. So we'd like to encourage you to go to youtube.com/Ruyonga and just play it over and over and over again and just have fun, enjoy.
Which rappers work for you when it comes to the females currently happening now?
To be honest, like, the only ones I know, and I mean, I like both, are Tushi, Rechore. Like, I don't really know other people who
are
doing it.
Getting married, man.
Let's play the video.
Is that you to call me? I don't.